Denzel was like a little kid. He was excited to get back in there and do these things.
He didn't want a lot of martial arts type fighting. He wanted straight, kind of street, slick, creative fighting.
He takes care of business. You don't want to get in his way, but it's not with a gun.
I haven't looked at what we've done, but I know I win.
You all right?
The person that did this was highly skilled, possibly military training. I don't think it's someone we've encountered before.
First thing I said was, it should be fast, but it should be personal so that I could still see him as a character within all this movement.
He made it very clear, maybe to the chagrin as us as producers, and I'm sure Denzel's agent too, that he didn't want body doubles. He didn't want stunt doubles doing the stunts.
Me and Denzel talked. I said, let's have him be quick with his movements, but let's slow it down so that you can see him do it. And he rehearsed those things much faster than even what you saw. And he was doing it all. And then when I saw it, I felt like I don't want to lose the power of who he is as an actor. So we brought Keith in, our stunt coordinator, who is a Navy SEAL. And then I made it very close and personal.
It's just one of those deals where you almost have to see him like 95% of the time. We wanted him to do it all. That's why we started about a month before shooting in LA and started training him.
We'd work together and do sort of a mixed martial arts workout three times a week.
There's some variations of many things. There is some amount of martial arts, but most of it is, you know, street fighting and cage fighting. You know, things you learn along the way, like I learned from the military. Special abilities, special forces, techniques.
You come here, you gotta let it go.
He got Denzel on a schedule that I cannot believe he got him on. He had Denzel boxing, training, fighting.
Once we got him going and working out every day, and I'm not, you know, bragging him up, but he's pretty damn quick.
Denzel would not do the movie if he had to use a gun. He wouldn't have done it.
Hands where I could see him.
It is a staple of big Hollywood movies, and we believed that we could do something a little different here, that he didn't have to use a gun to deliver the impact that he does.
He uses his physical skills and takes what you have and uses it against you.
When you are the equalizer, you walk into a room and there's two or three guys. You scan the room while you're having conversations. So if a fight does break out, you want to use everything in that room on the defense.
Well, there's your chair. There's the camera there next to you that could be slammed into your head. Everything's a weapon.
I met with a friend of mine who does these things for a living. He laid out all these different things in the room. He said, look, if you're in a bar or the place, these are the things that would be useful to me. He pulled out these corkscrews and did this, and I immediately saw Denzel, because Denzel boxes every day. He's on the set boxing.
I talked to a lot of Navy SEALs, guys who've done hand-to-hand combat. They can tell when they go in a room who's going to get up first.
16 seconds.
When the scene starts and the fighting gets ready to start, one guy comes in and that first move on him may be quick.
That's nice.
Then the second guy's on him, and then, you know, that move is even quicker.
Yeah, leave that one. And as I reach, you can reach. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Which is later than this shot.
Perfect. Correct.
Once McCall throws somebody or kicks somebody a certain direction, then that gives us time to deal with that next person that's coming in.
These things don't last long. It's not gonna be, 5 minutes of action.
It's gonna be actually really 15 seconds of action. Brutal, real hardcore action.
He grabs him and all of a sudden that's what that is. The guy's throwing punches and he's blocking him. It's like a boxer. Well, it's not like he kills you from a distance. He gets in your face and he's watching the light go out in your eyes.
Denzel, fortunately, can play that better than anybody.
Poignard.
He wanted us to believe that anything and everything that Denzel Washington's character does in this movie, he could do, because he is doing it.
He's done very, very well. I'm proud of him.
You're gonna feel the hurt. You're gonna feel the pain.
We have probably 6, 7, 8 kills in this movie that you have never seen before, and you will never forget.
What happened?
Hit it on something stupid.